Maria, Mariana, ma Mariana, kuno mubala teba mukwana. Maria, Maria, Mariana, ma Mariana, kuno mubala teba mukwana. Big woman, big woman. Girl, me love how you talk so. Girl, when you talk, me can't tell you shut up. Simply fine when you talk, baby. When you talk, I'm just a blackout. Jagalanti, tell your body boy. No visa, baby, got no passport. No money, boo, no visa too. But baby, me give you the comfort.
This is Power Breakfast, and this morning that beautiful music that you just saw there is by none other than Ugandan artist Apass, who happens to be with us in studio. So welcome to Power Breakfast, thanks for being here.
Thank you so much, I'm humbled to be here.
And welcome to Kenya as well, I guess.
Thank you so much, Kenya is lovely.
Right.
Yeah.
So you are a reggae and dancehall artist.
Yeah, most people would say that.
Why did you choose that specific genre of music? Were you inspired by anyone in particular growing up?
Yeah, a couple of artists. Listen to Shaggy, listen to Bob Marley, and much many artists. Mm-hmm. That's why I don't feel like I'm reggae and dancehall. I feel like I'm an artist. I just do music, and any beat that comes to me, I try to do justice.
Right.
Yeah.
So let's go back to the beginning of where this all started for you. Is it true that you actually started in the church?
Yeah, I think most artists start from church. Church is very good practice because you get to learn so many things. And I did church, sang around, but it was always jokes. But when I came to really like doing music, mm-hmm. like seriously, I think it was 2003, I felt like I needed to do music. I think I was in my S1, so the journey started from there.
Mm-hmm.
Look how we're here.
So you stopped the jokes and became a
singer. Yeah, you know, when you're young, you're just having fun. It's nothing serious. You're not really saying, oh, I want to be an artist, or mm-hmm. you're just doing it for fun.
Yeah.
So
at what point, I mean, it couldn't have been easy in the beginning, right? Because
yeah.
you're still trying to get your name out there, you're
yeah.
trying to get people
yeah.
to know who you are.
Yeah.
At what point were you like, I'm going to take this seriously as a career?
I think in 2013, I decided, I felt like I need to take music serious. I was already doing it, but I was never putting it out there.
Mm-hmm.
So we recorded over like 300 songs, but we're never putting out anything.
Songs.
Yeah, we have more than that now.
Wow.
And like we're recording so much, but we never felt like putting the music out there. But in 2014, I felt like I think I should start. So when I started, everything just came in play because I had something different from so many of my competitors.
Mm-hmm.
So when I came through, it was something brand new and refreshing
mm-hmm.
for the music scene
mm-hmm.
back home in Uganda and now in Kenya.
So what would you say is it that, you know, keeps you apart from your competitors, like you say? What was that thing that you brought to the industry that wasn't there?
I think I worked 10 times more than anyone. And besides working 10 times more than anyone, I have special talent with words. Like I have different lyrics, concepts. And so many people are very good, but they do not have like so many concepts when it comes to music. And I've mastered that, and I'm still learning. I'm a learner.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what was the response of your family, let's say your parents,
yeah.
Deciding to take up music as a actual career?
My mom is a pastor. She's a church person.
Okay.
But she likes that I sing, you know. Yeah. But though she's selective with what music she would listen
to. Does she watch your videos?
Yeah. She watches some of them. And with my dad, he's very open-minded, and he loves what I do. He loves most of the music I do. I'm even surprised to what songs he likes. He'll like a song that is too dancehall, and you're like, really? You should be liking these songs that are subtle, you know?
Right.
But he chooses to love the hyper songs.
So they never tried to sort of veer you into maybe you should sing gospel or
never.
Anything like that?
Never. Personally, I feel like I want to do a gospel album probably next year. I'll be finishing it, recording all the songs. We already started. But I do not feel like I should be triggered to do certain genres, certain music. I do what I feel. Mm-hmm. I am the boss. I'm not an employed person. That's how I feel. Like, mm-hmm. but I choose. I have to choose what I like.
Right.
You know, I'm a leader. I'm not a follower. I'm not ready to follow he, her, or what the old lady has to say. I follow what I feel, and I try as much as possible to have a good feeling about what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. That means it will be nice, and yeah. I'll be happy about it. But if I'm forced to do something, I don't think I can come out to my best. You know, it's not natural.
That's a good attitude to have.
We give thanks.
Now, speaking of choosing, you've chosen to work with some big names.
Yeah.
You did a song with Conscience.
Yeah, much.
How did that happen?
It's crazy. It was like a joke. After a performance I did, I was singing and Conscience was coming on stage after. So I can't do my set, you know, perform the jams. I was sick on that particular day. Mm-hmm. So I tried to do my best. I sang my heart out. I do not like to mime. I love to sing. I don't want the song to be playing and I'm miming. I really don't. But sometimes we do it if it's like TV or whatever. Right. But I sang, and after the show he said, I like what you do. So backstage is like, I really like your stuff. Keep doing what you're doing. You're a good guy. Mm-hmm. So from there, we exchanged emails after. And after a while he wanted to listen to more of my work so that we do a project. So when he asked for that, I sent him a particular song, which was Gamululu. Mm-hmm. He loved it. And the next day he sent me vocals. He had already finished recording.
Wow.
So we did not plan to do a song. It just happened because he liked it, period. Wow. And from there, the song is going places, mm-hmm. yeah, all over the world. And I'm very thankful, very thankful. Big up to Conscience.
Yeah, another example of if you put out your best, then, you know, good things will happen.
Yeah, most definitely. Most people want to put out their worst. Mm-hmm. They try, they're like, okay, let me do it. Mm-hmm. They don't give it their all. They don't have the energy to say, let me do this. Mm-hmm. You get?
Yeah.
And I am Mr. Go Do It.
Right.
That's my name.
So now that you're in Kenya,
yeah.
Do you have any artists that you're looking to work with, any collabs? I've got to ask.
Yeah, I'm not looking to work with anyone. Okay. I've already worked with someone.
Okay.
I've done a particular song with Avril, very lovely person, mm-hmm. respect her as an artist and as a human being. And there are more to be worked upon. We've already been connecting with so many Kenyan artists, even before I came. There are so many people we're working with. So stand by and keep close.
Watch
to the TV, you know? Yeah, it's going to be crazy and acrimonious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've had a lot of success in your career. Some of your songs are featured in the movie Queen of Katwe.
Yeah, so amazing.
That's, for an artist.
That's a Hollywood movie.
Yeah.
And to have four songs, there's so many artists in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So many artists in the world. I mean, a Hollywood big franchise like Disney says, we want four songs of yours. That is amazing.
And how did you feel? What was going through your mind when
I was escalated. If you have elevators and you've been in one, I was escalated.
You were.
I felt humbled, mm-hmm. but it did not come as a surprise. I work hard, but it was overwhelming just to see that the response and what they wanted, and they even wanted a particular song I had to do for the movie, and I had to watch it even before.
Before
it was out, then watch that part very clearly and did my best, and I'm happy that we had like four songs,
mm-hmm.
and just to have that work be out there in the world is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I give thanks.
What inspires you to make music? Do you have a particular inspiration, or you just kind of, you seem like a guy who just lets it kind of flow and come to you?
You're right. I let everything come to me. The universe is so beautiful. There's so much energy in the world. If you're free and just try to relax, things come easy. If you try to push so much, you may crash. And I try as much as possible to, like if I'm in studio, I just want to listen to the beat. If I love it, if it comes that I feel it now, I sing. I may not feel a beat now. I may feel it 2 weeks after. Mm-hmm. So it's just the vibe. If the vibe is right, mm-hmm. everything connects.
Yeah.
And that's how I do my music. I just sit in studio and vibe. I may do 5 songs, 6 songs in a day. I may do one. I may do none. So it's just like that.
Yeah.
Vibes.
The vibe.
Yeah.
You've had a lot of success, like I mentioned earlier. You've got endorsements that you're working with. So what's sort of the next step for you? What else do you want to achieve? Is it in a Hollywood movie?
Yeah. I don't know. I wouldn't say that I'm looking out there to say, well, let me get to this level or let me do that. I just want things to go step by step. But I want to progress, you know, but on my terms, mm-hmm. you know. I'd love to get to the next level. I would love so many more people to listen to my kind of sound, because it has something different to mm-hmm. offer to the ears, you know, to whoever is going to listen to the jams. So I just can't wait to do that. The rest, I'm just open.
Mm-hmm.
The universe will decide. I may die tomorrow. My motivation is death. I just want to do my best every single day.
Mm-hmm.
So if God helps me to get to the right mm-hmm. level, or to things I don't even imagine,
mm-hmm.
because there are so many things that happen that you don't call for, but they happen.
Yeah. When you look at East African music in general, you know, I'm sure there are young artists who see your journey and your success and want to have that.
Yeah.
Is there any advice you would give to someone who's at the place you were years ago and you're still figuring things out?
Yeah, I would say one thing. So many artists feel like they want what another artist has. But it's very wrong, because in the end, everyone has a path. Everyone has a journey, you know. And you never know, it may be different. You may look at what I have done and feel like probably you can do that. But maybe you're not born to do that. Maybe you're born to go another path and still make it and have your own story. Have your story, own yourself, and just follow your heart, because in the end, that gut feeling you have inside you, it sparks so much to make you who you are, because everyone is different. We are all different. We have all different fingerprints.
Mm-hmm.
If we are just the same, I think we would be boring.
Right.
So I just don't want any other Apass. I want someone to be them. If you're Annette, Janat, whatever your name is, be that, mm-hmm. you know, and try to own whoever you are.
Right.
I just feel like most artists look up to others and keep looking up to them.
And forget them.
Look up to the person, mm-hmm. appreciate what they do, but be yourself.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
Just be yourself. I feel like an artist should be themselves.
I love it.
Yeah.
So you're going to be back here on Citizen for 10 over 10 tonight.
Yeah, most definitely.
So we're looking forward to that. I'll be there alongside Willis Aburu, so we'll see you again this evening.
Thank
you. Is there anything
thanks.
Else that we should watch out for? Maybe if you want to give out your social media handles, you can do that.
Yeah, most definitely. If one wants to reach out to Apass on Instagram, it's iamapass.com. It's verified. And Twitter, same thing. And on Facebook, it's the same thing. You just have to do that.
I love it. I love your attitude, Apass. It's
thanks.
A pleasure to meet you, and thanks
it's
for stopping by Power Breakfast. Like I said, he will be on 10 over 10 tonight. He's going to perform, hopefully, so you can catch him then. But for now, we are going to wind up the show with a little bit more music from Zawadi Band. And like I said, 10 over 10 is hot tonight. Busy Signal will be in the building. Apass will be in the building, and many others. So it's going to be a really hot show. 10 p.m. here on Citizen TV. We will see you then. Dibanj, all the way from Nigeria, the Coco Master. How can I forget? He'll be there as well. So you don't want to miss all these A-list celebrities and awesome performers. So music from Zawadi Band, and of course, Citizen Extra coming up right after Power Breakfast.
Sakatonda kubaya ina plani sakalontu ngenzena neva sakucharani wendi wena badikali nchakubabo you are my darling siri kusibya njala, ekibuga nja kitambula.